We've set three bolts in epoxy. When they started drilling on this one, the concrete chipped, and you know, so it's hard to keep our bolt in the right place. So what we're gonna do is actually bring the column over, or one of the extra base plate templates or something, and set it down and over drill one of the holes to a 7/8, and use that as a template to hold our drill straight while we go in, since it chipped out. So we'll go ahead and let these three set up. Here we did get all four holes nice, and it's important when you're doing epoxy, a few things that you're gonna need. A hole brush, you gotta clean the inside of these holes, and you're gonna need compressed air and something to get that compressed air down in the hole. And then brush again. I do it two or three times, four times, until I stop seeing much dust come out of the hole. So every time you brush it, you're gonna make a little bit of dust, but we're just trying to get any loose stuff off the walls of the concrete. This is a really nice tool to have, something that mixes the epoxy for you. They do have epoxy that is two-part epoxy that comes in a single tube, and you just use a regular old caulk gun, but these double ones are nice, and they don't kill your arms and your fingers. And you can see how easy this stuff just comes out. I don't know if it's kind of in the shade here, but it really just comes squirting out, and it's kind of just where you have to get it by feel on how much epoxy you need to put in there. If you overfill it and you put the bolt in, the epoxy is going to overflow. Take some pressure off this, and I'll pick the good end and the bad end of the rod, and just kind of push and twist. And here, I didn't get enough epoxy in the hole. Let's just let her slide down in that one, and I'll give her a few more squirts. We don't need the epoxy to come all the way to the top. We drilled down 12 inches, and all we need, air bubble. And all we actually need here, I think, is 8 inches of depth on these particular bolts. So we don't need the epoxy to come all the way to the top of the bolt, but it'll look better and make everybody feel better if it does. I kind of made a mess there. Now it's going to take this epoxy a couple of hours to kind of tack up. So I'm just going to leave them loose in the hole until I get all four in, and then we'll square them up and make sure that they're level by using the speed square. And the speed square, or any sort of square, is another good thing to use while you're doing the drilling, just to make sure that you're going in straight. You don't want your bolt coming off at an angle. Got in there. So a little heavy, that's okay. We can just scoop that up. We don't want that to cure like that, because it'll interfere with the column or the base plate of the column when we go to put it on. Oh, I got that one dead on. Congratulations, Eric. We cleaned up one side with an angle grinder so we'd be able to get a nut on easily. So I'm just looking at which end I want sticking out. And if you're gonna do something like this and you want an extra template or something like that, give us a call. If you're gonna try to do this work before the building arrives, we may be able to get you, you know, like one of these in the mail or something. I'll show you what I'm talking about. This is just a piece of scrap steel that we had in the shop, and we just went ahead and punched holes on the machine. So we can make this. Like I said, this is scrap, but it does take time, so we'll charge a few bucks for it. So we can use this to adjust. After I clean up the epoxy, I'll come back and do this again, just to make sure. But that is about as good as we're gonna get, so I'm pretty happy with that. Look, they think it might be too hot, so they're using the leaf blower to try to cool it down. I don't think that's a problem, fellas.